Welcome back to the channel. Today's video, I'll be covering the integration of Copilot into Excel, and more specifically, how this new feature will allow quick analysis of data, as this new AI feature is likely something Microsoft will continue to build upon. And I do plan to make videos of Copilot in Word and PowerPoint as well, to cover more of the Microsoft 365 programs. So subscribe if you're interested in seeing that. But for today's video, I'll be using a practice dataset that is using car data. It's available on my website. If you'd like to download it, the link will be in the description. But with this new integration of Copilot, if we click anywhere in this dataset and press Control A to grab everything, there'll be this little icon, which will be the Copilot logo, that if we click on, it will have different options that we can choose. But first, we'll need to allow this to be uploaded to our OneDrive, so the email that we use with this Excel account. So if we click on Ask Copilot, or if in the Home tab, we go over to the right and click on this Copilot tool, we'll need autosave turned on, which will upload it to our OneDrive. So we can turn on autosave and just click on our email. And so now we'll have some different options that can be suggested, whether it's writing a formula, perform forecasting, create a table, or split columns. So this will create a forecast using Python if we click on this. So we can click, hit enter. And this will also be the advanced analysis if we click on this little icon. It will be the Get Deeper Analysis Results Using Python. But since we already have it over here, we can click Start. And so here's the results of that deeper analysis. It loaded it into a data frame. All of this could be done manually using Python, but this will auto-generate the Python code, create a data frame, which just stores the data. Then it's giving us the distribution of year, so the different model year, and then the amount of cars for each model year within this data set. If we scroll down, be the aggregate average miles per gallon per model year, which will be the different years, and then the average miles per gallon. So as we go up in years, we also go up in miles per gallon. And then the forecast of miles per gallon using a REMA model. And this will stand for autoregressive integrated moving average, which will be a statistical way of trying to predict the average or the mean for a different series. And so all of this was done with one click, being the deeper analysis using Python. But we can also go and just type in any question that we have or something that we'd like to generate. So we can type a prompt such as, can you create a bar chart for the MPG by origin? So this will be the different countries that these cars were built in. And so now it generated a bar chart for the mile per gallon average of Japan, Europe, and USA. And there's also suggestions over to the right, such as analyze the relationship between miles per gallon and weight using a scatter plot. So when we click on that, it will generate a scatter plot with the weight being at the bottom, with the lower weight having better MPG, as you would expect. So this can make it very easy for someone to get deeper analysis without knowing all the technical ways of creating charts with Python. And this will be great for newer users of Excel as well as experienced users, as either way, it can just help create some of these formulas much faster. But if we go back to the sheet one, which is where the raw data is, and we click on this, it'll have different suggestions. So these won't generate anything. It'll just suggest a formula column or certain conditional formatting, as well as summarize using a pivot table or chart or teach me something about Excel. So if we just click on one of these, such as suggest conditional formatting, we'll need to click on stop advanced analysis. And then we can copy back this prompt of suggest conditional formatting, which we'll need to re-highlight the table. So if we go back to here, we can click on suggest conditional formatting once again, and it will come back with the different suggestions. So you will need to have the raw data highlighted, and we can highlight cells above the average in column horsepower. And so now we can apply this if we just click apply. In our data, it now highlighted all the different horsepower rows where they are above the average. So this integration will be useful, and as they build upon it, it'll become more and more useful. And I do plan on making future videos getting deeper into the different use cases for this. But I do think the best way to learn this would be getting in here and asking questions yourself and seeing how it can help you speed up some of your workflow. But if you enjoyed this video, remember to like and subscribe so you don't miss future videos. And thank you for watching.